Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. LED masks, I'm talking about them today. Should you or shouldn't you? I'm going to tell you about my journey with them, a little bit about two or three different kinds, how they work. I'm going to look at a little bit of data with you, a couple studies, and I'll reference them if you want to look in deeper. The more you do at home, the better it is, whether you go to clinics or not, whether you want to age naturally. This would be considered a natural way. It's light therapy. A lot of people like that idea, and of course it's something you can do at home. If it takes a little longer at home than in the clinic, where more powerful devices can be used, it's not a problem, because at least it might be more cost effective and you don't have to leave your home. People don't want to leave their home these days. So let's look at a couple. We'll dive in, and at the very end I'll tell you also two tricks that you can do to make them work better. And I'm going to tell you which one my favorite is. Which one might you consider? In the links here below this video, there's more info. In that section, I'm going to put a little time frame so you can watch what you want to see. As well, I'll put some links to the devices that I like if you want to study them more. In the comments, of course, I want to hear your comments, what ones you are using, and people learn from you. If you're using one at home, how you're using it, and what you're finding beneficial for your skin, we all learn. So use that as a little form for yourself. I certainly, as you see, answer a lot of those questions, and don't forget to subscribe. We're gonna talk about galvanics and a few other things down the road in the next few months. I know you love galvanics as well. I'm gonna look into that data. LED masks, let's start. So this review isn't sponsored in any way. I purchased everything on my own. I go to many shows and I get in the beds. They have beds with LED lights. There are panels. There are handhelds. And in fact, hopefully I'm not blinding you here, but a handheld was my first introduction. There's a show called The Aesthetic Show. And about 6 years ago, before the show, they sent me this handheld. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that story when we get into it. But that was sent to me many years ago. I did not pay for that one. I didn't even end up stopping by their booth. Those shows get pretty crazy and busy. And then there's two masks I purchased on my own, and I've tried others on, but that's what we're going to focus on today. Of note, there are the handhelds like I showed you, there are the masks, and then there are LED panels. So on the community, I posted and I asked the question, what most people want me to review. And it looks like we had about 2,000 people, over 2,000 votes. 24% used the handheld. Now these are, I think, great, especially if you want to use them on the body. And I personally never used it on the body. And then 57% said to review masks, and 19% neither. I would not use them or have tried it and it was useless. But 57% liked or used the masks. So that's what we're talking about here today. That was my introduction into LEDs. To understand this fully, I want to take you through and just show you what we're talking about with LED lights, because when we look at the different masks, the number of lights in here, the energy, the distance from the face, all of those factors are going to determine in many ways the efficacy. And I'll go through each one. I'm going to tell you the parameters and the statistics on each one. To understand it fully, we need to look at the light spectrum so we know what we're talking about. So if we look at this diagram here and we start at the far left, in the UV area, around where you see the purple colors, you see the light goes superficial. And UVA and UVB, think B for bad, that's the worst type of sunlight or wavelength for your skin, because that causes a solar elastosis and it causes sun damage and brown spots. You see it's superficial. As you move across, you see green and blue. Some of these masks have blue that work more for acne than anti-aging. You can see they're fairly superficial. As you move across, you get towards the red wavelengths, or between 700 and 1,000. That's what we're talking about here. Notice how they penetrate deeper, the same layers we talked about yesterday in the video entitled How to Boost Your Collagen Naturally. If you're going to boost collagen, you want to be in the deeper layers. When you see up in that diagram, look at ND-YAG. That's why I'm well versed on this, because we use that for laser hair removal. And when I had multiples of clinics, laser hair removal back around 2005 was the most popular treatment in the clinic world, med spa world, dermatologist in terms of laser and rejuvenation. Botox and fillers weren't even really talked about. It was laser hair removal followed by IPL or intense pulse light. So you really had to know this well, because with the IPL device, and you can see the head of my device here, and here are the filters you can see. You put the filters in, same device. And now you know how with an IPL or a broad-based BBL device, you can target hair by way of the wavelength, reds, browns, and as we go up towards that red spectrum, you can get skin rejuvenation. But all to a degree, when you're using a device that powerful, can also get the hair follicle, so you have to be careful. In this case, we don't have the power to do it, but we're at that collagen building depth. So that might tie a few things together for you in your mind when you're thinking IPL, laser hair removal, LED. It's a fascinating chart. I could spend an hour talking about this. For those of you who watch my videos on erbium YAGs and CO2 laser, as you go up towards on the right, you can see where they're showing you the erbium YAG versus the CO2 and the depth of penetrations. So let's look at two of them. Let's look on the box. Let's see what they claim. And then I'm going to look at a couple studies, and we're going to see what the studies found. But if I'm reading, here's one. Okay, this is the current body. Okay. And see if we can get it in focus there for you. And this one on the box, this is what it's saying. Using professional technology found in clinics and salons across the world, the mask is clinically proven, here we go, to rejuvenate the skin with just the power of light. We know, yes, you can rejuvenate, no question, the power of light. IPL that I just talked to you about, some of the worst burns in the world will occur from an IPL if you're not careful. Those have more power, but they're very powerful treatments. Light absolutely works. And we're gonna look at studies on this wavelength, but just to say, yeah, okay. Using LED red and infrared therapy, we just saw where that wavelength is, it works with your body's natural processes to tackle the signs of aging. And we did say that the red LED did go to that level. Okay, so I'll show you that one, but before we go to the studies, let's just look. Here's another one. This is from Dr. Dennis Gross, and this is another mask. Some of these masks, do you remember in the early 70s, there was a hockey goaltender, Jerry Cheevers, and he would wear a mask like this, and when he got hit with a puck, it left a black mark, and he would leave the black mark on there as kind of his signature. And I remember that mask because we played street hockey as kids, and Jerry Cheevers, Boston Bruins for you East Coasters. So this is FDA cleared. I think this is worth talking about because a lot of devices clinics use, there's FDA approved, and then there's FDA cleared. That means they piggybacked off the clearance of another device to say, this is similar to something else, so the FDA will clear it. So FDA approved versus FDA cleared, but they are both FDA cleared devices. Here's what this one says. For the reduction of fine lines and wrinkles and the treatment of acne. So this one from Dennis Gross, this is blue as well. Again, I think we'll do a whole nother video on acne because acne is a moving target, very difficult. But I do know these masks can work very well for that. What I wanted to look at on here for you, they have the instructions. They also have some before and afters. But one of the things I noticed when I first purchased this one, probably about a year and a half ago, I tried to look for this study. I couldn't find it. But there's a study on the back. Now, understand, I can go into my clinic and create a study, however many people, and I can come up with whatever answer I want depending on how I design the study. So when we look at studies, of course, we're looking for double-blinded, placebo-controlled, prospective, so looking forward studies. And one of the ones today I'm going to show you is biopsy-proven. That's pretty amazing. But what they this study that they cite here, over 97% of subjects showed overall improvement in fine lines, wrinkles, skin tone, and acne. Now, it'd be nice to read that study or get a hold of it. Be interesting to see. Understand this to give you an idea. Botox in clinics is one of the highest satisfaction procedures ever. Almost nothing matches the satisfaction because it works quickly, it's effective, it stops lines, and if you pick patients carefully, it's like 97% effective. So that's very high for 97% of people. And on our community poll, it looks like there's going to be a higher percentage who did not maybe like them there. Maybe, I'm gonna extrapolate, maybe 7 or 8% did not like these. So 97% is very high. I'm a little suspect on that. Let's go and we'll dive into actual clinical trials and see what we found there. Okay, so let's look at this first one. This is from Science Direct. Now, a prospective, randomized, placebo-controlled, double-blinded, split-face clinical study on LED phototherapy for skin rejuvenation. Pretty amazing. I mean, what more do you want? It is 2007, but hey, LED light hasn't changed. Let's dive into this one just a little bit because this looks like you might not need to go any further. So if you look here, light emitting diodes are considered to be safe and effective in skin rejuvenation. Now, I looked at many studies, all of them talk about safety. And a lot of people are gonna ask me about what about eye safety? Everything I've seen has shown them to be safe for the eyes, not causing harm at least. I mean, I wouldn't go light these up in your eyes, but for the use of LED lights and what we're using for skin rejuvenation and the power here, they've been found to be safe. So they investigated the efficacy, which means the effectiveness of LED phototherapy for skin rejuvenation. That's what we're interested in this video, skin rejuvenation, through the comparison with three different treatment parameters and a control. And so if you look down here, they looked at 830, 633, we saw those on the graph, and they did different studies using combinations and alone, and then they did a sham treatment light. That would be your control. You always want a control. That's what makes it very hard to study skin, because there's no real good control for many reasons. Many, what we call confounding variables, even different sides of the face get different amounts of sunlight. So having a control is very important. And so serial photography was done and 3-month follow-up was done. The investigator, so there was an investigator assessing it and they were double blind, and I talked about that, very important. One thing I wanna point out to you here is this line, read this. Skin specimens were evaluated for the histological and ultrastructural changes, alterations, status of matrix metalloproteinases. Now, coincidental, the video we did yesterday, and I'm making this one today, but we talked about matrix metalloproteins in the one that's entitled Boost Your Collagen Naturally. And I talked about those, and here they're talking about those. Very good study here. Who was the author of this? We'll have to, there's a group of authors, we'll have to commend them. But here's the important part, what they found. This therapy was well tolerated by all patients with no adverse effects. Now, every study I saw, we never say in medicine there's no side effect. You'll almost never hear a real doctor say never, because there's always something. This is as close to, from reading the data, something with no side effects as I'm finding. We concluded that the 830 and 633, remember those numbers, LED phototherapy is an effective approach for skin rejuvenation. And they did biopsies. Everyone's gonna ask, where did they biopsy? The forearm, they did the forearm, they found subjects. So this was proven by way of biopsies. This is also important from the conclusion. We concluded that the 830 and 633 LED phototherapy is an effective, safe, well-tolerated, painless treatment for skin rejuvenation. It sounds great. From the clinical aspect, the non-thermal feature of LED phototherapy, so it doesn't create heat. I think some of the cheaper ones, be careful, might give off some heat. If you have melasma, be mindful, or any photosensitivity. But it goes on to say that that is a significant advantage, that they're non-thermal. It doesn't disrupt the stratum corneum or the outside of the skin. Because we could achieve effective rejuvenation of the aging without inducing any thermal damage or wound in normal skin, we recommend the use of combination wavelengths to maximize the effect through utilizing advantages specific to each wavelength. So they talk about multiple 830 and 633 as being effective, but pretty good indication. Let's look at one more. So this study was in Clinical Aesthetics and Dermatology. More recent, it's 2018, so that's nice. And Dr. Avalon, a friend of mine, I was pleased to see, did this study. That was fun for me to see that. She's an amazing physician and researcher. And the study included a literature review of published studies, including LEDs with frequency of 415. It's that blue range we talked about for acne. 633 and 830 infrared. And we looked at that on that continuum earlier, and that's why it was important that I wanted to show you that light spectrum. So at the end, we determined that phototherapy using LEDs is beneficial for a range of medical and aesthetic conditions in dermatology practice. The treatment displays our excellent safety profile. That's what we've been reading. Okay, we're into a bit of a long one today, but I think this is really important because these are devices that actually work, and I want you to have the most efficacious treatments at home and ones that aren't dangerous. And this is fitting the bill. We're into a long one today. Do you guys drink these Pellegrinos? They're good. I'm getting addicted, I think. I had to look and see if there's caffeine because I'm enjoying them. So if we're comparing the masks, the Dennis Gross and the current body, this is a flexible one. They're both FDA cleared, like I said. This hockey mask style does have more wavelengths, so 630, 660, and 415 blue. So this one is the one that has the blue light for those people that are interested for acne. I'm going to do a whole other video on that, but this does have the blue. And if you then take the intensity, this one's 61, it's 30 in the current body. In terms of the treatment times, I'm often on the fly. I want the less treatment time possible. If you look at Dennis Gross, they recommend 3 minutes for this one, whereas this one is going to be more like 10 minutes. Sometimes you don't mind, you sit back, you relax, it's kind of soothing. But for me, I like a little shorter one most of the time. The distance, of course, we talked about that, of the LEDs from the skin, 3 millimeters, it's fairly close for both. I would say this might be a little closer to the skin. And then price-wise, this one is about $100 more, so typically. This one does have 100 total LEDs, but that includes the blue light as well, and this one's around 49 LEDs. So there are differences. This one, I'll just show you the lights on this one. You hold this in, and then you put this on. That looks a bit crazy, doesn't it? And then if you press it again, you get your blue light, you press it again, and you can get both. So that gives you an idea of how that works. This current body, of course, you turn it on. There's no blue in this one, and then you put it on. In terms of comfort, and if it is 10 minutes, where this one is the 10 minutes, this is a little, to me, trickier to put on. They both strap on, but this one is a little more comfortable. If you don't want to relax and you want to read, this is very easy to watch TV and do your things. The studies have shown, as I mentioned, that there's no harm to the eyes that have been demonstrated. So if you don't want to close your eyes and relax, you can do other things, read, watch TV, which is really nice sometimes. I guess of note here, I plug this one into, when I do use it, I plug this one into a charger for an iPhone. It's a USB, so I have other USB chargers around where I can power this up, or you can throw it into your computer and it can power up. So if you don't have an outlet for the current body one, there you could put it into another power source. But this charge lasts me for a week. If I use it every day, this is rechargeable. So those are some subtleties. Now, which one do I pick and what are my hacks? So it may have sounded that I'm leaning towards this one. And if you read that into the way I'm Speaking about them, I would say yes. I don't have acne as a problem typically, so I don't use the blue at all. I typically use just the red, but I do prefer this for ease, for comfort, and for the 3-minute option, and I do definitely keep it on longer at times, but that would be my suggestion. Now let's dive in to my two hacks. So how do you get these devices to work better, quicker, and be more effective? There's two things you can do. Number one is pre-exfoliate. When we talk about exfoliation, there's chemical and physical. I like physical. Whatever you're doing at home to get that, a lot of people I know have microderm and microderm-like treatments, if you get where I'm going. And doing that before the treatment kind of prepares the skin, helps better absorption, and helps the light and effectiveness get to those deeper layers. Number two is concomitant retinol or retinoic acid use, whichever one you can take. Don't allow inflammation, so you have to know your individual dose, of course, but I recommend using it 1 hour before or immediately after use. It prepares the surface of the skin, allows it to work better, and allows the machinery of collagen building to be more readily available for this to work more effectively. You might have your own hacks. I put a list up here for all sorts of things, vitamins, things that you can do at home, home treatments to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant. Stay tuned here, like and subscribe. In the info section below this video, you'll find links to everything we talked about. Stay tuned.